Hello and welcome to the fourth part of my video about letter writing. In this part, I will discuss about inquiry letters, requests and appeals. So let's first have a look at inquiries. An inquiry letter is a formal letter written to inquire about services or products. So maybe you want to go for a tour and you want the details. Or maybe you want to join some course, some kind of classes, and you want to inquire about the fee, about, you know, how to go about it, or you want to know about the prospectus or any other details. So you make an inquiry letter. As the sender of an inquiry letter needs information about something, the inquiry letter must mention the contact details of the sender where the said information has to be sent. So let's have a look at the tips. Follow the formal letter format for the application part. Formal letter format has been explained at length in part one of this video. And the format goes like sender's address, date, receiver's address, salutation, subject, body, complimentary clause, name, designation, and signature. Then for the body, one can straight away come to the point and ask for the required information in form of a list. So that, you know, making a list always makes the things simpler. So you should definitely go for the list system if you want, if you do not want to make any mistakes and get full marks. If you want something from the receiver, then it is a good idea to send a self-addressed envelope and detailed contact details. So let's have a look at the complaint letter here. You are Rajni Rahul, living at E95 Sector 12, Dwarka. You read an advertisement about short-term course in computer programming by Z Computer World, Pitampura, Delhi. Write a letter seeking all relevant details of the course. So there, according to the format, sender's address, date, receiver's address, subject, salutation, and then we straight away start with the topic in the body. I have seen your advertisement about computer programming course, which appeared in the Hindu dated 7 July 2016. Prima facie, it appears to be appealing and interesting. I have passed my senior secondary exam with 85% marks. I want to join this program, but before that, I would like to know the following details of the program. And then we go on with the list, what all details we are looking for. Duration of the course, timings and fee structure, eligibility criteria for the course, number of students in a batch, facility of evening or part-time batches, whether recognized by any university or not, facility for transport, future prospect of the course. So basically, see, whenever you are asked to write an inquiry letter in the examination, so you think about, you think that what all information would you require if you are to go for that course, and include that information. Include at least 6 to 7 points. It is for 5 marks. So you want to score better. Then let's have a look at the closing line. Please send me a copy of prospectus, as I'm sending a self-addressed envelope with this letter. Send me the information at the earliest. So here, you know, it's a good idea to send a self-addressed envelope if you are looking for some information. And in this case, it has been sent. Yours sincerely, Rajni. Similar example. Now, this is the one about, you know, inquiring about tour. You're organizing an excursion to Manali. Write a letter to the director, tourism department, Manali, asking to supply the information on terms and conditions of conducting excursion. So going by the formal letter format, your sender's address, date, receiver's address, subject, salutation, and straight away coming to the point. This is with reference to your advertisement in the Hindustan Times dated 14th April 2016 about conducting tours. In this connection, I may inform you that the student council of the school wishes to escort a group of 50 students to visit Manali from 15th May to 25th May 2016. Therefore, I would like to know the following detail about the excursion. And then there are the details. Tourist spots to be included in the trip, availability of the accommodation, boarding and lodging charges, students' concession, if any, details about adventure sports. Please supply me the above details at the earliest so that we can finalize the trip. You are also requested to send me a prospectus containing all the relevant information, hoping for an early response. Yours sincerely, ABC Secretary, Students Council. Now, a small note here, even if, you know, there is no reference to any advertisement, you can still start your letter, you know, I am so and so and would like to inquire about, you know, I'm planning a trip to your hotel or to your city and I would like to, you know, inquire about the following things. That can be another way to start your letter if you do not have a specific advertisement at your in your information. Now, coming to requests and appeals. A request is an act of asking politely or formally for something, a request for information. And an appeal is a serious, urgent or heartfelt request. Now, tips, of course, it's a formal writing, formal letter. So, formal letter format will be followed. Sender's address, date, receiver's address, salutation, subject, body, complimentary clause, name, designation and signature, and plus the enclosure. Enclosure, we studied about it in job application with resume. So basically, whatever we are enclosing along with the letter. While the appearance of a letter is important, the content and tone will determine whether the letter really does its job. So you have to, it's a request. So you have to have a subdued tone. You have to be polite. Review any relevant policy and pay particular attention to what the decision maker needs to know to consider an appeal or request. So when you are making an appeal or a request, if any documentation or copies of documents are required, then you need to be ready with that. That is the information which should be included in your letter, and the information should also be included in your letter. Let's have a look at the examples now. Okay, now here a small note that the text of the model letter is exceptionally brief. Most appeal and request letters require a page or two. However, we are just understanding what a request and appeal is all about. So formal letter format, sender's address, date, receiver's address, subject, salutation. I'm writing to request a special examination in course 101 on March 12th, the date of the regularly scheduled exam. I have to appear in court as a witness. I have enclosed a copy of the court summons. Now here, the applicant knows that, you know, it is something he's appealing to the principal that he be excused from writing the examination and a special examination to be scheduled for him. And he's given the reason and he knows that, you know, he might, it might be, you know, imperative for him to produce the proof. So he has enclosed a copy of the court summons. Thank you for taking the time to consider my request. Please contact me by email or phone if you have any questions. Yours faithfully, XYZ. Enclosure, copy of court summons. So let's have a letter, look at the letter of request here. Now write a letter to the manager of a local bus depot, pointing out that there are very few buses flying on the route you use in morning and these are invariably late, causing great inconvenience to the daily passengers. So sender's address, date, receiver's designation, the manager, address, subject, very few buses flying to Krishnanagar, salutation, and you begin your letter. I want to draw your kind attention to the frequency of buses from Charbagh to Krishnanagar between 6:30 a.m. and 10 a.m. The buses flying on this route are highly irregular, causing great inconvenience to the daily commuters. I travel by bus number 470 and 471 from Charbagh to Alambagh, but I have to spend hours waiting for a bus. Often I am late for work and I have to take a taxi, which is beyond my means. Because of this irregularity, the buses are overcrowded and do not even stop. Considering the fact that this is that it is a highly populated area, more buses should be plied in this route, at least during the peak hours in the morning and evening. So there the request has been made very, very politely. But before that, it is mentioned how inconvenient it has become. If possible, please ply more limited buses or point-to-point buses on this route for the convenience of the daily commuters who are already harassed. Please look into the matter and take appropriate action without further delay. So we see the tone is polite. Politely, he is requesting and he's given the suggestions. So thank you. A complimentary close. Yours faithfully, Neelam Yadav. Okay, so that was all about the letters. Last but not the least, make sure you adhere to the format as it carries marks. Make sure you double check for grammatical accuracy and spellings as they also carry marks. Leave adequate number of lines between paragraphs to make it look clean. Presentation is very important. Read a lot of letters to get an idea to write the letters. I hope I've been able to do justice and explained various formats of formal letters. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe and share. Thank you.